the equaliser from the centre half forward then, Martin McHugh. Tony Brady here, Donal Reid got a hand to it and into the path of Kieran Keeney. Kieran Keeney inside, Martin McHugh. Martin McHugh turned around. This is Paul McGettigan, shot blocked. The block was by Tony Brady, but it comes to Pádraig Carr. Paul McGettigan, Martin McHugh. Are they overdoing it now? Martin McHugh with the shot, and Martin has got the point. And I think Martin McHugh is injured now this time. Yes, the picture's telling their tale then.
Martin McHugh then hopefully will be recovered fully from that injury he got in Clonus. But Galway, of course, are the more experienced side. Johnny Hughes, the long-serving defender, is one of the two Galway men who played in the 74 semi-final. Tom Nocton's the other one, and he's back tomorrow after injury for the first full championship game this summer. Peter Lees recovered from injury that kept him out of the defence last year, and his namesake Richie Lees moved to midfield, and most of these Galway men having tasted the semi-final fare only last summer. Well, Galway haven't been very impressive so far this year, but they are a mature side and they did prove solid champions when they played in one of the best Connacht finals that we've had in recent years. Galway parading with historic rivals Mayo before their second consecutive final, and here in Castlebar, the champions couldn't have expected as easy a win as they'd had in Tuam last year.
A packed house here in McHale Park. TJ Kilgallen taking that one down. It runs loose to Pat O'Neill for Galway. Bustling his way through, finding the loose man, finding Val Daly, crossing the 45-metre line. The early shot from Val Daly goes over the bar. The equaliser by Val Daly. TJ Kilgallen up towards Jimmy Lyons. That's cut away smartly by Stephen Keneevy. The Galway fullback up towards Brian O'Donnell. He's got it. This is Brian O'Donnell, a chance of the equaliser, and he puts it over the bar. Brian O'Donnell feeds it back to Brian Talty. Up towards Gay McManus it goes, fisted on forward. Michael Gavin gets back there. Stephen Joyce is in with a chance of a goal. A goal, a goal, but what a mistake that time. Richie Bellrother. Brian Talty. It comes down to Willie Joe Padham and a chance of a point for Mayo, and that's another one from Willie Joe Padham. So 10 minutes to go to half time as Richie Lee is robbed by Richie Bell. Breaks it loose as far as TJ Kilgallen. Up into the corner. Pat Dixon for Mayo to Willie Joe Padham, rounding Brian Talty. A chance of a score, a good shoulder from Seamus McHugh. Jimmy Lyons and Willie Joe Padham. It's a goal! 25 minutes gone. And Willie Joe Padham, who set it up initially, pumped it up in the air, ran in after it and fisted it past Paul Recoin. Pat O'Neill. The support comes from Johnny Hughes. And not a good tackle. The referee allows the advantage to Johnny Hughes. Gay McManus. Val Daly as Galway move into top gear. The shot from Daly, it skims off the crossbar but goes over the bar. A point by Val Daly puts Galway back in front. Willie Joe Padden breaks it down, but it comes to Val Daly for Galway as he's trying to break loose. The referee allows him the advantage. Here's Barry Brennan, checks, then into the corner towards Stephen Joyce. Here's Joyce going by Henry Gavin, leaving it instead for Pat Keneally. The shot from Keneally looks good, and Galway go back in front. Thanks to Pat Keneally, who came on there as a sub at the start of the second half. Brian Talty grabs that one down, goes by Martin Connolly. Up to Gay McManus. Anthony Egan is there, and McManus has got inside the fullback. Thundering towards goal, a chance of a score here, surely for Gay McManus. The point. Extending Galway's lead to 110 to 18 for Mayo. Pat Keneally tearing away through the centre. Spraying it out to Stephen Joyce. A good pass and a good shot. And Stephen Joyce extends Galway's lead. 112 to 19 they lead. Stephen Joyce to Brian O'Donnell. Going by the entire Mayo defence, then holding possession. Gay McManus gets what could be the insurance score. It's 113 to 110.
So Galway through to the All-Ireland Series again and hoping to get to the final after 9 years. It was a much stiffer test this time and against Mayo, and after that Castlebar win, these were some of the views expressed.
Well, really, when you get out of Connacht and get into Croke Park, you don't have to work very much from the psychology point of view, because everybody is in there with his hat in the ring, everybody trying to make the team. We have about 25 very good players, as we had on our programme there today. And as it proved, Pat Connelly coming in there and kicking a mighty pint and playing well. And also, we have down the list, we have quite a few more players capable of doing that. And it's marvellous to see it.
Are you good enough to win an All-Ireland?
I will tell you that after the All-Ireland semi-final, perhaps.
Well, now going into that All-Ireland semi-final, Galway, of course, are the ones with the more recent Croke Park experience, having tasted the big match atmosphere there only a year ago against the eventual champions Offaly, and indeed being beaten only narrowly.
Stephen Joyce coming out to get it. And very nice passing movement there as coming down for the ball there, Barry Brennan. Brennan into the centre now, and Valdini takes the shot and he sends it over the bar. A point for Galway. Sean Lowry for Offaly. And the referee awards the free to Offaly, quickly taken. Richie Connor from way out the field, feeding now to Brendan Lowry out on the left. Brendan keeping it in play out there. Oxy Morden is with them. Ball back to Matt Connor, a lovely high ball, and it's a point! Oh, what a lovely, lovely point! Ball deflected into the centre there by Stephen Keneevy. Getting it down to Moss Tierney. Oh, a lovely bit of fielding there by Richie Lee. Richie's kick is high, and Richie's kick is good. If there was a good point by Matt Connor a moment ago, a sky point, there was a sky point too. And the Tullamore man kicks it into the centre of the field. Fielded there by Richie Connor. Johnny Mooney with it now. Johnny, pretending he was going to hand pass it, takes a kick and sends it over the bar. A point by Johnny Mooney. Twisted further up through the centre there by Jerry Carroll. But Brian Talty nipping in. This is Gay McManus and coming to help him there on the far side. Up the field with Barry Brennan. Barry Brennan up now to Tom Nocton. Nocton in front of the goal. It's a goal! It's a goal for Galway! Straight down the middle. Intercepted there by Pat Fitzgerald. Intercepted there by Tomás Tierney. Tom Nocton back now to Brian Talty. Talty, a nice high ball, and it's gone over the bar. A lovely point by Brian Talty. And the man of great kicks today, Barry Brennan. And I remember an incident some years ago when a ball blew away when a penalty was being taken, and the player did just that, and the referee gave a free out. And they remember it in Donegal too. That one kicked by Barry Brennan, and Barry over the bar, his third point. What lovely kicking by this Galway man. Richie Connor bringing it down, keeping it in play. Johnny Mooney coming down for it. Cross into the centre now, and this is Brendan Lowry. Goal! Goal by Brendan Lowry. Seamus McHugh. And here come Galway again now. Gay McManus trying to find somewhere to get rid of it. Oh, misjudgments there by Offaly defence. Val Daly taking every advantage. Back now to Willie Joyce. Brian Talty. Across now where Pat O'Neill has it. Pat going through. A shot for the halfback. The point for the halfback. 13-13. Richie Connor. And Johnny Mooney with the ball. Dynan. And the kick half blocked down there. This is Brendan Lowry. And there is the lead for Offaly. Brendan Lowry getting the ball there. Switches all round the place here now. Offaly 1-11, Galway 1-10. Offaly in the attack again. Richie Connor. It's high and it's over the bar for a point. Richie from out on the far sideline.
Well, the Connacht champions are now hit by the absence of Barry Brennan, their accurate right half-forward, as you saw there. Barry has joined us in the studio this morning, along with Pádraig McShay, the assistant team manager for Donegal. Barry, is there any chance at all that you could play tomorrow at any stage of the game?
No, Mick, unfortunately, no chance at all. I gave up hope about Wednesday when the consultant doctor told me that it was totally out.
Yeah, and naturally, very disappointed, I suppose.
Yeah, rather disappointed, but I've sort of got over it at this stage. I'm looking forward to a good match tomorrow from the sideline.
What's the atmosphere in the Galway camp as you've been preparing for this like?
It's obviously one of confidence and optimism. If we learn from last year, this is what we feel at the moment, if we've learned enough from last year, we shouldn't miss the chances we missed last year and we should be there at the end.
Well, turning to Pádraig McShay, Pádraig, talking about atmosphere, how does it compare this summer with 74 when you captained that team against Galway and 72?
I would have to say, Mick, that it is totally unique. I have never seen interest like it in Donegal before. Everybody in Donegal seems to be coming to Croke Park tomorrow. And let me say that they're not coming just to have a day out. They're coming maybe to have a look at Croke Park and see what it will be like in the second last Sunday in September.
Oh dear, well, you were telling me a story beforehand, in fact, that your local golf club is having its captain's prize tomorrow.
Yeah, the captain's prize is on.
Clash of dates, isn't it?
It's on tomorrow in Bundoran, and it's somewhat unfortunate, but it's just one of those things. When the captain arranged his prize, we didn't know that we would be in the All-Ireland semi-final. We were hoping we would be, but we just weren't. Possibly, sure.
How significant in the build-up to this semi-final was last year's under-21 victory, which was a great occasion, the first All-Ireland for Donegal. Has that meant the atmosphere is even greater this time?
I think winning the under-21 last year was very significant because it was Donegal's first ever All-Ireland success, and everybody savoured it very much, and they got the taste, they got the feel of what it was like to win an All-Ireland, and now they want to go and try very hard, do everything in their power to win the big one.
OK, Pádraig, thank you for joining us, and Barry Brennan, we hope that you'll be back in football very shortly. So that's Donegal against Galway, and it's a fascinating pairing indeed.
Semi-finals will be live on RTE2 tomorrow from 10 to 2, and you can see the highlights of the senior match at Sunday game at 10:15 on RTE1. It's time for racing now. Here's our racing correspondent, Noel Reid.
Thanks, Bill. Just squeezed in between the Golf and the Atlantic. We have two races from Newbury. The favourite here in this first race, the 2 o'clock, is 42nd Street, 3-1. Be My Valentine, Follow Me, Follow, and Sejada are all 4-1.
Out in the field. Well, they were here about a week ago to get used to the pitch, and well, they're out on it now, about a quarter of an hour before the throw-in, getting even more used to it. This young team from Donegal that seems to have brought the entire county with it. I don't think I've ever seen so much green and gold, and I mean that, Kerry, and I mean that awfully too. Donegal maroons Galway. Well, that speaks colourfully indeed. Out in the centre of the field, there's Donal Reid, one of the speedsters of the half-forward line, a player who certainly showed his worth in the Ulster final. And there is Martin McHugh, the sharpshooter-in-chief. All that cheering you hear is just a continual cheer, first for the announcement on the electric scoreboard that Eamon Coughlin is the world champion 5,000 metres runner. And also this continual bubble of excitement that has absolutely captured the whole of Donegal. And the players loosening up out in the centre of the field. Seamus Bonner, a man who stands alone. The only man to have won 3 Ulster championships with Donegal, 72, 74 and 83. And here he is today, trying to do something that they didn't do in 72 and 74. That is, get into the All-Ireland final. And Paul McGettigan down there, number 9. Paul, who played with Galway, believe it or not.
But he lives in Galway too, but he is declared for his native Donegal, and he will be one of the thorns in the Galway side today. Galway, we love you, and that's just to show you that everybody here hasn't got green and gold. And there is Charlie Mulgrew. Charlie, who was off because of an injury in the Ulster final, he missed that one. He's back today, and this is one of the reasons that Donegal are so cock-a-hoop, because they feel that what they could do in Ulster in the Ulster final without Charlie, they can do even better with him. And here is Kieran Keeney. Kieran, who played all over the place in Clonus in the Ulster final, he is one of the sharpshooters of the team. And indeed, the main strength of this Donegal team is the forward line, which seems to move hither, thither and yon, to the utter dismay, more often than not, of defences. Whether it will bamboozle the defence line of the mighty Galway or not remains to be seen. And in the goal, well, this is another link with the 74 team. This is Noel McCall, who played in 74 when they won the Ulster Championship and were defeated in the All-Ireland semi-final here by Galway with the score 313 to Donegal's 114. There are four members of today's team were on that team, and one of them is Noel McCall. Another we saw a few moments ago, Seamus Boner, and yet another was Paul McGettigan. The fourth member of the team, in fact, is number six, Michael Laverty, the captain, but we'll be seeing him later on. And while all this excitement about the team is going on, the Artane Boys Band, or should I say the Artane Band, are standing down in front of the Hogan Stand with their new girl drum majorette. And she is 14-year-old Michelle Gunning, who comes from County Offaly, a daughter of Jody Gunning, former football star and indeed referee. And there she is, standing proudly and now confidently, although there were a few nerves behind the scenes before she came out first, waiting for the arrival of Galway and the grand parade. Well, the team of the Donegal men, it's spiced with youth. And here is the youngest player on the field. This is Joyce McMullen. Now, Joyce McMullen may seem a strange name. He was christened Joseph McMullen. They used to call him Joe, but now they call him Joyce. One of the streaks of lightning on the attack for Donegal. He has scored a goal and 7 points in the championship so far. And here come the Maroon Boys from Galway. Galway seeking their 18th appearance in an All-Ireland final. Galway, a team of experience. Galway, a team with experience on the sideline, experience of the big time. They today out against the speedsters of Donegal. And you can look at that for anxiety to get on with the game. Tom Nocton in there in the centre. Tom Nocton just settling the ball there. He's been off the team because of a motor accident for quite a while. He's back now to take his place as captain. And they're all coming in. The subs and everybody. Everybody having their picture taken. In white, back of course, is the goalkeeper, Pádraig Coyne. The subs breaking away now, leaving just the team. The fair-haired man on the right there in the back row, that's Brian Talty, whose form and indeed whose ability to really get into it today can be one of the real telling points in this game. And so Galway break now and do their bit of kicking around before the grand parade. And there is Peter Lee, one of the stalwarts, a very steady defender in the centre half-back position, and indeed his clash with Charlie Mulgrew will indeed be one of the highlights of the game. And here, of course, is Johnny Hughes. Johnny, I won't use the word veteran, I'd use it the other word, most experienced player on the Galway team. A great half-back with great Galway teams and a great defender with this team, trying to prove indeed that they merit the name of greatness. A dedicated footballer, a great sportsman, and fit as the proverbial fiddle. And the goalkeeper, Pádraig Coyne, that we mentioned a few moments ago, just limbering up and Porter getting ready, as it were, to dive left, right, or up in the air, or anywhere you like. And this is Gay McManus, the full forward. Gay, who has scored 3 points. That's he down on the extreme right of the picture with the ball now. And he has scored 3 points in the championship so far, and is one of the very elusive members of the Galway attack. And this is the Galway line-out. Stephen Keneevy at full-back, the tall Stephen, who certainly is a great man to field balls. And then the attack with Stephen Joyce, the smallish Stephen Joyce, up there top of the left. So from the tall men in the back to the small men in the forwards, this is an effective team. And now we have the team from Tyrconnell, the team from Donegal. And here we have a team that's based on last year's under-21 All-Ireland winning team. No less than six of that team in the lineup. And for experience, there are men like Michael Griffin at full-back, or Martin Griffin, I should say, at full-back, and Seamus Bonner at full-forward. Experience and youth. Now this is Joyce McMullen again, and I have an idea we'll be seeing quite a bit of Joyce as the game goes on. That's Brian McAniff there, just gone walking to the right. This is the brain behind the Donegal team, and Brian is in an absolute tither at the moment. I was down in the dressing room about a quarter of an hour ago, and while Brian normally is effervescent and dancing and bouncing, Brian was a really tied-up man, and he's now having a go at Joyce McMullen to get on with it, even though the game hasn't started yet. And if they can play as well as Brian talks, well, Donegal will be happy. And out in the centre of the field is referee Weeshie Fogarty, and on the right is David Foley, one of the linesmen, and on the left is Tom Furlong, the other linesman. Weeshie Fogarty, who comes from Killarney, associated with the Legion Club down there, and a very well-known and popular official, not only down in the kingdom, but indeed all over the country. He has refereed All-Ireland semi-finals before, and has refereed matches in the very, very top grade. Well, Paul McGettigan going over now to join his colleagues for the march around. And if you think you've heard cheering before, just wait until what you're going to hear when this starts. Because as I said before, everybody from Donegal, and even all the Donegal people in Dublin, and that's covering a fair bit, they're all here. And when the music starts, so too will the cheering. So the Donegal team with their green jerseys and the gold hoop, they look like ferrymen, somebody said. And with the Galway team in their maroons against the grand parade led by the Artane Band.
problems.
Donegal have won the toss and have elected to play with the wind from right to left, from the canal goal to the railway end. The roll of the drum and our national anthem. Start of the game now. The Artane band leaving the ground. Paul McGettigan in the foreground on the right for Donegal. Richie Lee on the left for Galway. And behind Richie is Brian Chelty. And Anthony Molloy is in behind Paul McGettigan. Referee Weeshie Fogarty throwing in the ball and the game is on. Brian Chelty for Galway, but this is Richie Lee. And the ball out over the sideline, a line ball that was exactly the way the hurling semi-final started a week ago. Line ball far side of the field to be taken by Brendan Dunleavy. Nice ball gone right through. Charlie Mulgrew going out trying to get it. The ball snapped up over there and Martin and McHugh taking a shot there but sending it wide. Martin coming out, getting the ball, coming out from his corner position, getting it, taking the shot, but it's wide. Now, as I said, Donegal are playing with the wind, but it is a trappy wind in over that hill 16. In the minor game, we saw quite an amount of, well, miskicking and shooting that wasn't of the best. Cordy Coyne to take the kick out. Richie Lee going up for it too, and bringing it down, Anthony Molloy, and now it is Galway going into the attack, and here they come. Nice pass over there by Brian O'Donnell. Martin Griffin, down the centre now to Charlie Mulgrew, feeding the wind, running on to it, Donald Reid. Stephen Kennedy. been tackled, but the kick out got a very long one. Ball down over there to Seamus McHugh. Seamus is fouled and there's a free to Donegal. Matty Colwyn to take this one. Matty, who's a guard then, in fact has been on night duty all week and left his training every night to go in to take up night duty at 10 o'clock. Well, it's daylight today and Matty takes this one way up the far side of the field. Val Daly. Val Daly fouled there by Michael Laverty and a free to Galway. Galway free just outside the 45-meter line. Seamus McHugh with it. And gone in over the end line and wide. Still no score, just about 3 minutes gone in this first half. Noel McColl placing the ball for the kick out. Well down the far side of the field. Held over there by Seamus McHugh for Galway into Brian Talty. Long ball up the field. Cut off back there by Tommy McDermott. Kicked out to Brendan Dunleavy. Good relieving clearance. Brian Talty nearly holding that one, but not quite doing so. And it's Paul McGinnigan going away with the ball now. Left footed and wide, and the score remains. No score. Paul seemed to be gone through with a scoreable chance there, but that's easily said from the stand. The ball went wide. Cordy Coyne with a kick out. Cameraman moving his lens. Into the centre of the field again, the wind catching it. Nice bit of feeling there by Richie Lee, and he gets a free for holding. And the free to be taken, very quickly taken indeed there, by Peter Lee. Paddy Kelly now with it, back into Peter Lee. Nice bit of holding there, nice bit of feeling there by Des Newton. Des Newton for Donegal. Nice ball up the field, Seamus Bonner going out for it with Kennevy. Kennevy tips it out to the wing. This is the ball cleared out now. Matty Coleman getting into the action there and now in the middle of it all and coming away with the ball, Brian O'Donnell. Or is he coming or has he touched it on the ground? Well, Weezy Fogarty is right beside him and breaking away with the ball now is Martin McHugh. McHugh coming into the centre. And from 45 metres out, a lovely ball out here to the corner. Lovely feeling there by Johnny Hughes. And Johnny gets a free, and there's a free out from about 13 metres from the Galway goal. Lovely bit of fielding by Johnny. Free to be taken by Cordy Coyne. Still no score, 5 minutes gone. Val Daly coming down to the midfield to get it. Selling a dummy there to Michael Laverty. Dangerous ball. Still a dangerous ball. Tom Nocton trying to get it in there. Comes back out and the first score of the game by Dane McManus. And you'll see how that pass came out from Tom Nocton. Tom was under pressure. Here comes the ball coming in from Val Daly into the goal mouth. Little bit of dithering there on the left. It looks as if it's going to be brought out by Newton, but Tom Nocton gets a hold of it and passes it out there to Gay McManus, and it's over the bar, the first score of the game after 6 minutes of play. Galway 1 point, Donegal no score. And the referee awards a free to Donegal in the centre of the field. Well, not quite centre. It's about 65 metres out from the Galway goal and about 10 metres in from the near sideline. Michael Carr is going to take it. This is a halfback who's gone into the scoring records this year, but not with that one. In where Seamus McHugh gets it, out to Matty Coleman. up along the far wing. Conor O'Donnell robbed there. Now getting the ball in the centre. Anthony Molloy in towards the goal mark. And it goes in towards Paulie Coyne. And the referee awards a free out to Galway from their own parallel ground. Paulie Coyne. Oh, a low one, not a very long one at all. Seamus McHugh getting it, and the referee penalising the Donegal man for pushing in the back. Matty Coleman to take the free, just inside his own 45. Wynn catching it a bit. And a little bit of dithering around there, Coleman getting it. Getting the ball way out this side of the field, but out over the sideline, and a line ball for Galway. Certainly up to now, the Donegal lads have not got into any dashing, speedy antics like a lot of people expected, but the game is young yet. This is Pat O'Neill now to take this line ball just inside his own 65-metre line. Brought down in the centre and cleared out there by Michael Laverty, who is fouled as he is kicking the ball, and there is a free for Donegal, and it is where the ball landed, and where the ball landed is about 60 metres out from the Galway goal, and Joyce McMullen is going to take it. 20-year-old Joyce standing back now. Ball deflected out this side. Kieran Keeney. Back now to Seamus Bonner. Bonner takes an angle shot, and it's in the upright. Still in play. And cleared out now to the far side of the field, where there is a line ball for Donegal. Matty Coleman being in the right place where that ball came down off the upright. Brendan Dunleavy. And the ball being cleared out the short route, if you like. Brian O'Donnell, Brian Talty. Brian Talty robbed over there. Referee waving the play on. As this dropping ball comes in, Johnny Hughes gets his hand to it. Goes out into the centre to Peter Lee. And out to this side of the field. Stephen Joyce coming down for it. Tipping it back into the centre where Ricky Lee gets it. Up now to Gay McManus. McManus now being chased by Martin Griffin. McManus, a high one across the goal mouth. Who's going to catch it? Coming out now to Stephen Joyce. He catches it, and he sends it over the bar. Stephen Joyce, the left corner forward, moving over to the right, getting the ball after all kinds of dithering there and sending it over the bar. The score, Galway 2 points, Donegal no score. And just over 10 minutes gone in the first half. Noel McCall with the kick-off. Joyce McMullen. And the ball coming out on the wing there to Golden Reed, and Golden Reed has sent it over the bar. The first score of the game for Donegal, as a deflected shot came to Golden Reed, and Donal has sent it over. And so after 10 and a half minutes of play, Galway 2 points, Donegal 1 point. And Corey Coyne looking for a nice spot. You think he was in Royal Dublin. He's just finding a good spot now from which to tee off, as it were. And the breeze catching that ball. Very nicely fielded by Joyce McMullen. McMullen going up the field now, being chased by Pat O'Neill. But the Donegal men have got this idea of kicking the ball way up in the air into Seamus Bonner on their minds. This time he's got it the hard way, and the ball out over the line for a line ball for Donegal, as Seamus McHugh sent that one out. Martin McHugh. Porticoin in the goal. Back out to where Martin... if he knew that was coming, he'd have stayed where he was. But it just beat him by about 5 yards. Anyway, he gets another kick. 12 points he's latched up so far in the championship. And deflected over there. Lovely point by Seamus Bodie. It was like a hurling shot. Like a hurling shot that Seamus Bodie swung his fist over his head and deflected it over the bar, following a lovely sideline ball by Martin McHugh. The score, Donegal 2 points, Galway 2 points, after almost 13 minutes of play. And that was the kind of an injection that this hitherto listless Donegal team probably needed. Porticoin. Straight down the middle again. Ball breaking on the loose to Donald Reid. Back to Brendan Dunleavy. Way up the field. Fielded by Seamus Bodie. And the lead for Donegal. Seamus Bodie, the hero of 72, 74. Takes that role again in 73 or in 83 as he sends that one over to make Donegal 3, Galway 2 after about 13 and a half minutes of play. Porticoin with the kick out from the 20 meter line. Ball coming down to George McMullen. Tipping it across to Donald Reid, to Martin McHugh, indeed Martin McHugh back now, and a shot in towards the goal, blocked down, cleared out now to this side where Peter Lee gets it. This is Val Daly, and Val Daly is slide tackle foul there, quickly taken free, intended to Brian Kelty, very nicely intercepted there by Anthony Molloy. And this is Seamus Bodie again with Stephen Keneevy. Stephen Keneevy's gone back for it, got it, and is fouled. Three out for Galway from their own 13-meter line. Donegal leading 3 points to Galway's two. Lowish one, Seamus McHugh. And this is Michael Carr. Kieran Keeney. Trying to run onto it now and succeeding in doing so very nicely as Charlie Mulgrew. Pretending to go right and left and leaves the ball behind. Comes back to Seamus Bodie. Ball deflected, pulls over now towards Seamus McHugh of Galway, and the clearance kept from going over the line by Brian O'Donnell. Added to by Richie Lee. And now the Donegal men coming back into attack again. Porticoin in the goal. Richie Lee in the centre of the field for Galway. And Des Newton coming up. And Tommy McDermott coming up too. Tommy McDermott getting it, and now a hand passing movement, and this is Michael Carr. And Carr takes the kick, that's hit the upright. Donegal 1-3, Galway 2 points, 16 minutes gone in the first half. And out in the centre of the field, the referee has awarded a free to Galway, and indeed is writing Brendan Dunleavy's name in his little book. Free to Galway to be taken by Seamus McHugh. Brought down, Brian O'Donnell with it now, free in for Galway. And referee indicating that it was a holding foul there. And this is where Barry Brennan is missed, because he would normally be the taker. But Stephen Joyce, who is no ham at this particular job is the man to take it. And Stephen sends it over the bar, his second point of the game, Galway's third, and that makes the score Donegal 1-3, Galway 3 points after just over 17 minutes of play in this first half. Stephen Joyce there, that's a goal and 5 points. He's contributed to Galway's championship total. Ron Kelty batting it down, but this is Michael Card, who's penalised for picking the ball off the ground. Free to be taken by Pat O'Neill, just outside. In fact, it's inside the Donegal 65-metre line. Val Daly. Lovely ball across the goal. If it keeps in play, Stephen Joyce has gone out to it, has kept it in play. They're trying very hard to work it through. This is Porty Kelly. Nice bit of ground football there. Back out now to Stephen Joyce. Stephen's shot is high. It's still in. No, it's not. It hopped on the line, kept coming out along the line of cameramen there, and just bounced out over the line. 1-3 for Donegal, 3 points for Galway. Noel McCall with the kick out once again. Donegal playing with a slight breeze in this first half, a tricky breeze. A lot of fidgeting and fooling going on around the place. Richie Lee up the far side, Brendan Dunleavy, Matty Coleman for Galway, Gay McManus, Tommy McDermott trying to keep it from going in, but fouls him as he does so, and a free. They're trying to make up their mind who's going to take it, and it looks like a Richie Lee take. Richie ground one, Martin Griffin. Powerful relieving clearance. Stephen Keneevy decides he won't race for the ball because it's going to be a Galway ball anyway. David Foley placing the ball just outside the Galway 45 metre line. This is Johnny Hughes. Donegal. Michael Laverty, one of the survivors of the 74 team and captain today, to take this one. Coming across from the far side. Reed's nice move in towards the goal there, but cleared out. A defensive relieving clearance there by Matty Coleman, but it did go over the line, and it is an attacking line ball for Donegal. Michael Carr to take it. Just 20 minutes gone in this first half. Dangerous ball. Knocked down. Joyce McMullen's shot knocked down there, and the free out for Galway. Stephen Keneevy now. This big Newbury Garda. Indeed, it's guard versus guard in there at full back and full forward. Seamus Boner is also a Garda. Centre of the field, this one knocked down to Brian Talty, and Brian right through. Brian O'Donnell with it now, being chased by Brendan Dunleavy. Almost robbed by him. Still a kick by Brian O'Donnell that's gone to the right and gone wide. And if you're keeping track of the wides, Galway have had 3 and Donegal have had 2. If you're keeping track of the scores, Donegal 1-3, Galway 3 points. And Noel McCall with his place ball. And from St. Eunan's. Van Kelty's twisted effort into Val Daly. Val Daly up now to Cody Kelly. Kelly running on. Oh, a save, but it's not over yet. This is Val Daly. And there's a free against Donegal, and it's on the 13-meter line. Stephen Joyce to take it. 1-3 to 3 points at the moment. Over the bar. Stephen Joyce's third point. Galway's fourth. The score, Donegal, 1 goal and 3 points. That's 6 points. Galway, 4 points. Stephen Joyce, who's been their scorer-in-chief today. And this is Noel McCall. Val Daly. Moving up to it now, Brian O'Donnell. And a nicely taken point on the run there. Brian O'Donnell taking his pass, taking his way through himself and sending it straight over the bar to make it now Donegal 1-3, Galway 5 points. And about 23 minutes gone in the first half. Trying to feed this wing. Pat O'Neill getting his fist to the ball. Deflected out this side. Charlie Mulgrew almost nowhere to go. Back now towards Des Newton. And a lot of loose kind of passing there. This is Tommy McDermott. Again, a lot of dropping the ball around the place by both sides. Paddy Coleman out to this side of the field. Pat O'Neill getting there before Joyce McNulty. And Pat, wholehearted player that he is, gets the ball up the field, but the referee penalises Donegal for a foul on Pat as he kicked the ball. And he is limping a little bit at the moment. A free where the ball landed, and Val Daly, and Pat has gone down. Pat has injury to his thigh, but the referee is say play on. Val Daly, now Pat is up, and Val Daly is going to take the free. Martin Griffin, astronaut Martin. Charlie Mulgrew. Away now come the Galway men. This is Joyce McCullum. And Donegal with this mania expecting, and well, it didn't happen there, it nearly did, expecting Seamus Bono to catch everything coming out of the sky. He caught that one at the top of his head, and Seamus and Stephen Keneevy got it out. This is Val Daly. Well, it could be described as dangerous, but the referee let the play go on. And that's Seamus Bonner in now towards Martin McHugh. And the ball hops out over the end line and goes wide. Referee wagged his finger there at that loose swinging kick. But no contact was made, which was probably just as well for Donegal. 1-3 to 5 points. Donegal leading by 1 point after 26 minutes of play. And Joyce McMullen again. He's fouled. And there is a free to be taken for Donegal, and just outside the 45-meter line, and little Martin McHugh is coming out to take it. Martin, who had an injured lung following the Ulster final, was a doubtful starter up to a few days ago, but here he is. The bottle is communal. Doesn't matter what jersey you have, you can have a swig, and I'm sure they're glad of it on a day like this. Score, Donegal 1 goal and 4, Galway 5 points. And the man from Kildare, the star of the under 21 team of a year ago, indeed the star of the senior team of this year. Val Daly with the ball again, and the referee penalises Donegal. I think Donegal are going to make a couple of switches, or indeed have already made switches around the centre of the field. We'll sort them out in a moment. Peter Lee, and the referee has awarded another free against Donegal for a push in the back. And his point in the spot, which Stephen Joyce has noted. And Stephen now to take this free, 1-4 to 5 points. And it's gone wide. Certainly unfortunate to hear that booing creeping in again as a player coming up to take a free. And just looking around in the centre of the field, so Donegal are as they were. And there's a change in the Galway team. Seamus McHugh over here on at the right, and Pat O'Neill over on the left in the half line. And a rather unnecessary trip foul there by Gay McManus, who shows just how he did it. Free to be taken for Donegal, just outside their own 45-metre line by Martin Griffin. Seamus Boner. Nice ball, but nobody in there but Galway men, particularly Peter Lee. And Peter is penalised for carrying the ball too far. Free to Donegal, just inside the 20-metre line, an awkward enough angle for most people, and I don't think one can include this youngster in the category of most people. Martin McHugh, there's his angle, there's his shot. 1-4 to 5 points. It's hit the upright again. That's the third time it's happened, and now about to be cleared there by Johnny Hughes, but Johnny obviously fouled, and a free out for Galway. It's amazing, three balls hitting the upright today and one of them winding up in the net. And the referee has awarded another free against Donegal, who have, I think, said something to him. Somebody has. That's a foul for a pushing offence there. No, I thought he was moving the ball up 10 metres. It did look as if somebody said something to him. Anyway, Brian Talty is taking this one just inside the Donegal 65. Des Newton. Donald Reid going for it. Well, there's a lot of body play going on here. Richie Lee's ball up the field. And out it comes again. And here comes Donegal on the move. This is Donald Reid. Back now to Paul McGettigan. Left footed to the left and wide. Score remains Donegal 1-4. Galway 5 points, 7 points to five. And 31 of the 35 minutes gone in this first half. And for the record, when they met in 74, Galway led 2-7 to 1-6 at half time. Tommy McDermott getting the better of the hop situation over there. McHugh. Well, he's using the off-the-shoulder jersey this season. That's Michael Carr with the ball now. Corey Kelly is after him, playing like the dandy that he is, but he can't get the ball in because it's scored by Michael Carr. And Michael, one of the best players on the Donegal team in my book, was the scorer of that one, the halfback who went up to be an attacker, sent it over, and it is now Donegal 1-5, Galway 5 points, and less than 3 minutes left in the first half. Ryan O'Donnell. Ryan Dunleavy trying to get out. Brendan Dunleavy trying to get after him, but couldn't. This is Tom Nocton now. Des Newton after him. Nocton for Galway, racing away up along the right wing now. Des Newton blocking his way. And the referee has awarded a free against him, and I don't know what it was for, to be very honest. I really don't know what that was. For me, the Donegal man stood in his way, and he did not shoulder him or punch him or anything like that. Maybe he did, maybe you saw it, but as far as what I saw, it is a strange decision. Val Daly to take the kick. And you hear what the crowd think of it. Over the bar, a point by Val Daly, reducing the lead to Donegal 1-5, Galway 6 points, after what I would think was a slightly strange decision. 33 minutes gone in the first half. Noel McCall. Ball breaking. Anthony Molloy well up the field. And a trip, a free for Donegal, a free for Donegal, as Seamus Bonner going for the ball appeared to be tripped, and the referee has gone up and signals that it is a free on the 13-meter line for Donegal. And it looks as if Joyce McMullen is going to take this one on the left side of the post. 1-5 to 6 points, nearing the halftime whistle. And it's over the bar, a point scored by Joyce McMullen. The score, Donegal 1-6, Galway 6 points, 1 goal between them, and about a minute left in the first half. This is Val Daly. Val getting inside Michael Laverty, and there is a free, and there's no argument about that one. Tommy McDermott being warned by the referee, thou shalt not do again, and Pat O'Neill placing the ball for the kick just outside the Donegal 45 meter line. Val Daly again blocked down. Gay McManus in position now, out for it, out in the corner, trying to make an angle for himself. A nice shot in towards the goal mouth. Noel McCall. Grabbed now by Peter Lee. Peter's kick blocked down, but fortunately for him, out to a waiting Gay McManus. And now to Pádraig Kelly. Kelly's kick blocked down. There's a scrum five or something up there. Tommy McDermott with it now. And away it out comes. There's the halftime whistle. Anthony Molloy getting the ball. There is the halftime whistle. And so, after an interesting first half without being spectacular in any way, Donegal lead 1-6 to Galway 6 points. And we'll be back with the action of the second half in a few moments.
everybody's getting these new tastes from Yoplait. New rhubarb yogurt and new hazelnut yogurt. Two delicious new tastes from Yoplait. With Allied Irish Bank's Cash Save, you can use the BankLink machines to put money into your savings account or take money out when it suits you, night and day. Talk to Allied Irish Banks about Cash Save today. The ins and outs of a savings account made easy. Join with Ford in an exciting driving experience. Take a Sierra on test for 24 hours. Sierra, with its stylish aerodynamic shape, already outsells all other cars in its class in Ireland. But only by driving it can you fully appreciate Sierra's outstanding qualities. It's a car that feels right from the moment you take the wheel. The ride isn't just smooth, it's supple, controlled, and beautifully balanced. The eager response to the accelerator, the crisp gear change, the positive steering and nicely progressive brakes, all add to the feeling that you're at one with the car. Sierra, Ireland's car of the year. Contact your Ford dealer and take it on test for 24 hours.
Free electronic typewriter with these copiers from CK Business Electronics, Galway. Donny Cassidy presents Foster and Allen's new LP, Maggie, playing tomorrow night Rustic Inn, Abishrool. Luxury living at Seacrest, Galway. You buy an O'Grady home and we'll buy yours. Huge selection of furniture and pianos at unbeatable value. Crockwell Furniture Centre, Galway.
And back here at Croke Park, the Artane band over on the far side of the field, but we did have a few moments ago four groups of young lads under the provincial flags. For Leinster, there were the boys of the Erden's Isle Club in Dublin. For Munster, the boys from Bishopstown in Cork. From Ulster, the lads from Ballybofey and Donegal. And for the West, we had Salt Hill representing Galway and the West. So these are lads who were representing the players who take place in Óg Sport na Gael. This great festival of Gaelic football, which is held in the Gormanston College from the 14th to the 18th of August. It is a festival which is sponsored by the New Ireland Assurance Company and indeed is for football in many ways corresponding to what Féin na Gael does for the boys in hurling. But right now the Artane band are entertaining the crowd in front of the Cusick stand. They'll be over our way in just a little while, but while they're over there, and for the benefit of those of you who may be switching dials and doing things like that, I'll give you a rundown of what happened in this first half. Galway settled down pretty well at two early points. Well, early in comparison with the rest of the scores, because we had to wait for 6 minutes for the first score. And then back came Donegal with four scores in a row, and they included a goal by Kieran Keeney, which putting them into the lead 1-3 to 2 points after 16 minutes. Then Galway had 3 points in a row, and that made it 1-3 to 5 points after about 23 minutes. Then Donegal had 2 points, and Galway won, and finally Joyce McMullen had the concluding point just before half-time. So the score at half-time, Donegal 1 goal and 6 points, Galway 6 points. And the minor game, Derry 16 points, Leitrim 3 goals and 5. And in the first game today, Derry 3-16, Galway 3-5. And in the first game of the day, Leitrim 2 goals and 6 points, Longford 1 goal and 6. So a victory for Leitrim. And in the front row, with the fire lighting behind them, is Mr. Brian Desmond, and alongside him the mayor of Dublin. And if you look back a little bit, you can see Kevin Heffernan back there with Paddy Moriarty, the big man of the ESB on the right. Of course, Kevin isn't exactly a little wheel in that organisation either. But no doubt he's not thinking of the ESB at the moment. He's thinking of Dublin and Cork, and if Dublin beat Cork, what they would do with the teams that are out in action here. Barry Desmond, I may have said Brian Desmond. Barry Desmond was the man, of course, that I meant. Well, you can see that the hill isn't exactly overcrowded today. One would think that it would be an ideal place to bask in the sun, as indeed you can see with all those bare torsos that it is, but it is by no means a crowded place. It will, I would say, be rather crowded next Sunday, and one wonders how Dublin and Cork followers are going to get on, let alone how Dublin and Cork footballers are going to get on. Well, there you are, up Donegal and half of Derry. Well, the Artane band more or less finishing their selection in front of the Cusick stand over on the far side. Michelle Gunning having a look over her shoulder just to see that the boys are following on. And she's about to give the signal, which will have them marching straight over this way. Artane band leave the ground. We have the news that the attendance today is 28,507. In 1974, when Galway and Donegal met, the attendance was 33,782. But maybe that day wasn't quite as fine as today. And maybe there was nobody playing golf out around Dollymount. Well, the crowd awaiting the return of the teams, and it'll be interesting to see if indeed any switches are made, because both sidelines are, well, very active and very thoughtful as to what changes might and might not be made, and it wouldn't surprise me at all if we had a change or two, if not at the restart very soon after. And here comes Donegal. They lead by 3 points, and they want to get on with the job. This is their third All-Ireland semi-final. Never before have they gone the whole way to the final. Can this be it? And looking round, the Donegal men that are out, I don't see any new faces. And Brian McAniff and Cordic McShee, the two former footballers and now the two sideline giants. What have they hatched with the second half that can keep Donegal in the lead? That is the question that the whole of Donegal, and the whole of Donegal is here, that is indeed the question they are asking. Now, any moment, we will have the other side of the question. What have Galway hatched inside? Matty McDonagh, great player of the past, now the chief mentor of the Galway team and a great footballing brain. What indeed can he and men like Bertie Coleman sort out to get their men into their 19th All-Ireland final? Somebody waving the traffic. So I think it's just a matter of seconds before we see a maroon jersey coming out onto the field, and here they come. Stephen Keneevy, the short journey over to the fullback position at the canal end. And just checking around to see any new personalities in there, and I don't think so. I see Thomas Tierney, but he's running over to the dugout on the far side. No changes in personnel anyway. And I will, when the game starts, sort out whether anybody is playing in a new position. Referee Wishy Fogarty standing waiting for the throw-in. Calling the players in to that little white mark. That's where they're supposed to be. Two of them are and two of them aren't. Anthony Molloy there on the left for Donegal. Richie Lee. And then hidden by them back behind Paul McGinnigan and Brian Talty, the fair-haired one. Second half is on. Richie Lee and out over the sideline, just as the first half started. The score, 1-6 to 6 points in favour of Donegal. Line ball to be taken by Brendan Dunleavy. Martin McHugh now. Matty Coleman after him. And the referee penalises Matty for a holding foul there. And Martin McHugh to take it. 13 metre line and 5 to 10 metres in from the sideline. Standing back. What a delightful kick it was. Well, 10 points to 6. 4 points between them. 2 minutes gone, or just less than 2 minutes gone in the second half. Corey Coyne with the kick out. Galway, the Warriors, the men of experience. Can they pull this one around? Nicely cleared upfield. This is Matty Coleman. Trying to open up a movement now. Paddy Kelly coming out to get it and grabbing it is Gay McManus. A dangerous lobbing, dropping ball, but it's just to the right and it's gone wide. Donegal 1-7, Galway 6 points. Noel McCall once again finding a good lie for himself. And against the breeze, this one not as long as the ones in the first half. Cody Kelly, Tom Nocton. Des Newton the wrong way, and Des comes back after, but Tom's shot is in, and it is just wide. I said at the beginning that down there around that goal, the breeze can be very tricky, very, very trappy indeed. The score still 176 points in favour of Donegal. Awaiting the dropping ball there, number 6 for Donegal, Michael Laverty, number 11, Val Daly. Brian Talty fisting the ball down. Brendan Dunleavy, Michael Carr. Seamus Boner's come way out the field. So also down there getting the ball out to this side now and getting it into his hand is Seamus Boner, who has come out field and is playing in the centre of the field. And Seamus trying to draw the backs out. They won't move. Up along the wing now, Donald Reid into the goal mouth. A tussle, the referee is going to hop the ball. He's going to hop the ball. One of the Galway men down injured at the other end of the field are out about 50 metres from the opposing goal. Referee going to throw the ball up. Up she goes. Seamus Boner. And he's penalised for carrying the ball too far. Meanwhile, Brian O'Donnell is being attended to down here at this end of the field. He seems to be all right. He takes his position. Stephen Keneevy takes the kick out. Martin Griffin up to the centre. Brian Dunleavy, in fact, and the ball coming now on the loose to Charlie McGrew. Charlie McGrew going upfield. This is Matty Coleman. Donegal really passing now. And Martin McHugh going for the ball and Pat O'Neill coming away from it. This is Brian O'Donnell for Galway. He's 30 metres out. And it's over the bar, reducing the lead. Brian O'Donnell, the scorer, making the score now. Donegal 1-7. And Galway 7 points. Tomás Tierney is coming on the Galway team, just checking with the referee, and going off is Patrick Kelly over on the far side of the field. Tomás Tierney, who has been off because of injury for quite a while, is on the Galway team. Val Daly. Val Daly has moved out to right half forward, and Tomás Tierney centre half forward as that ball goes wide. Donegal 1-7, Galway 7 points. One score between them. Brian O'Donnell seems to be all right. That number 12, he was down injured a short time ago, but has figured prominently in the play since. And here he is. No, it's gone to the left and gone wide. Still 1-7 to 7 points. Donegal leading. Brian, who incidentally works in the same office as Paul McGettigan in Galway. Today, they're on opposite teams. I wonder what they'll talk about tomorrow. Noel McCall once again. Brian Talty again fisting the ball down and Brian O'Donnell getting it. Des Newton coming across for Donegal. And it eventually goes to Matty Coleman. Tom Nocton trying to get away with it over there. Dave McManus is out there too and gone out with the ball. Bringing it out over the sideline, Michael Carr for Donegal. 9 ball for Galway, Val Daly to take it. About 18 metres out, in front of Hill 16, far side of the field. curling ball, curling round the goal and wide. And the score remains Donegal 1-7, Galway 7 points. We make it about 8 minutes gone in the second half, and we're just about 3 minutes away from our last score. Kick out by Noel McCall. Certainly Galway have had a lot of wides. They've had 9 to Donegal's 4. Stephen Joyce. But the referee penalizes Stephen for a push in the back or trip or something up there. Referee right up with the play. Martin Griffin to take the kick as Paul McGettigan comes out to take his place in the shadow of the stand down here. Michael Lafferty into Paul McGettigan. And the ball gone out over the sideline. It's gone out off Donal Reid, I would say. Linesman Tom Furlong running up. And it is a Galway ball. Paddy Coleman. Kept in play there by Donal Reid. Up down to Martin McHugh. McHugh pretending to go left and then right. Pat O'Neill is after him. And the referee penalizes Galway for a foul there. And he illustrates with his right hand that it was for pulling. And Martin McHugh is going to take this free. 1-7 to 7 points. That's the score at the moment in favour of Donegal. About 10 minutes gone in the second half. Members of the McAniff family sitting delighted there. Nicely held over there by Michael Carr. Andy Coleman. Brian Chalty. Out it goes now to Richie Lee. And it's gone wide, and Galway will have to pull up the proverbial socks now because they are 4 points behind and there are 11 minutes gone in the second half in a game in which Donegal show no signs of slackening off. Donegal 1-8, Galway 7 points. Held over there by Richie Lee. Brendan Dunleavy knocking it down. Jay McCann is picking up a very nice pass there from Val Daly and sending it over the bar. A very nice tip pass there by Val Daly to Jay McCann, who very quickly had the reflexes moving to catch that ball and send it over the bar. The score, Donegal 1-8, Galway 8 points. Just over 12 minutes gone in this second half. One goal between them. Trying to feed the far side of the field now. Anthony Malloy has his hand held there by Richie Lee and a free to Donegal. Michael Carr placing it for he himself to take. That's the 65-meter line just behind. Chips, a rather high one there that is fisted out over the sideline by Johnny Hughes as Kieran Keeney went for the ball. Michael Carr again with this line ball. Donal Reid over there. Johnny Hughes. Martin Griffin. Martin certainly an inspiring fullback today. And that one going out over the sideline on the far side of the field. Stephen Keneevy with the kick. The most clearly going for it, but beaten to it by Michael Laverty. And the free as Brian Kelty brings down Martin McHugh over there on the far side, and the referee is having a word with him. And I don't know what Brian is doing with the hands out wide, like I never touched him, because he wasn't looking from where we were looking. And Brian Kelty's name goes into the book as what one I suppose could describe as a personal foul. And you can see the popularity of Martin McHugh, not only that, but the popularity of the bottles as well, as the whole Donegal team seem to be gathered around to see if Martin is all right. Sergeant McKeely in there with them too. And indeed, David Foley has told the referee something or other, and he is calling down Johnny Hughes. Apparently, the linesman saw Johnny Hughes do something that he shouldn't have done. The referee didn't see it, and the linesman, quite rightly, reported it to the referee, and Johnny Hughes' name, uncharacteristically, is gone into the book. Now, free to Donegal, just outside the 45-metre line. And Martin McHugh's kick is high in towards the goal mouth. It's blocked down. That was Malloy. Free out. Anthony Malloy, that blasting shot that hit off some part of somebody's anatomy, didn't go into the goal, and the referee awards a free out to Galway. 15 of the 35 minutes gone in this tension-packed second half as Donegal lead 1-8 to 8 points. Nicely held by Richie Lee. Brian Talty. Brian O'Donnell. Richie Lee. And a shot that's high and over the bar, reducing the lead now to 2 points. As Brian O'Donnell got involved in that, and Richie Lee was the one who finished it. 1 goal and 8 points for Donegal, 9 points for Galway. 16 minutes gone, 2 points between them. Can Galway come back and take over? Can Donegal hold on? And here come Galway, Val Daly. And shooting like that won't help. That one's gone wide. Donegal 1-8, Galway 9 points, 11 points to 9. And Val Daly, who's been playing so well, had what seemed a scoring chance there, but it didn't really work out for him. Noel McColl is a busy man in this second half. Kieran Keeney is way downfield now, and Johnny Hughes has come after him, and Johnny Hughes is he was going to go for that ball in an attacking position. It is a linesman's ball. Johnny Hughes is now standing beside the ball, and the ball is 30 metres out from the Donegal goal. Reason he's there is that Kieran Keeney is there, his opposite number. Top of the left is now playing almost at right full back. That's Johnny Hughes with the ball now. Johnny's kick. Oh, Johnny, go back to the corner, back to the right back position. The score, Donegal 1-8, Galway 9 points. Well, I suppose Johnny's instructions from the sideline, wherever that forward goes, you go with him. Which could be carried to all kinds of extremes. Breeze catching that one. coming down now to Tomás Tierney. And Galway are kicking this game away. Another wide as Tomás Tierney took a shot. This one went to the right of the upright. Previous shots to the left of the upright. Who knows what will happen the next time. 13 wides for Galway and a total of 4 wides for Donegal. 1-8 for Donegal, 9 points for Galway. And once again, Brian Talty draws on the ball and fists it. Martin Griffin draws on the ball and kicks it up to her. Seamus Bowler has come out. Seamus is held. And there is a free for Donegal, quickly taken by Paul McGinnigan. Paul McGinnigan to Michael Carr up the far side of the field. Michael's shot is a dangerous one in the square. Dither in there. Back out it comes. Fisted over. From a very awkward angle, his fourth of the game, and the score again, 1 goal between them. Donegal 1-9, Galway 9 points. 19 minutes gone. Willie Joyce is on the game. Willie Joyce is on the game for Galway. Willie, the star of so many games, and Brian Talty is going off. And the kick out by Tory Coyne. Nicely held by Richie Lee. Feeding the left corner. Gay McManus trying to get out there. Martin Griffin hooshes them away. Gay McManus appeals for a free. The referee signals that it was done with the shoulder. Score 1-9 for Donegal, 9 points for Galway, and 20 minutes gone in the second half. Just one kick of a ball between them. Willie Joyce goes for that one, doesn't quite get it. Referee penalises Donegal for a foul on Peter Lee. Seamus McHugh to take it. Willie Joyce to take it. You name it. They're all out there going, 3 of them, 4 of them. Stephen Keneevy is coming up now and he's the one who's going to take it. There were 3 of them around it trying to make up their mind and Stephen decided it all. He's one very good kicker of a dead ball. Well, he may be, but the distance was right, the direction was wrong, and it's gone wide. And Donegal still lead 1-9 to 9 points. Charlie McGrew, he's moving somewhere. He got a word there from the sideline. We'll follow the play. Ball fisted down by Seamus McHugh. Upstairs Newton. This is Seamus Bowler. The Green Pimpernel, as it were. Very nicely tapped up there by Paul McGinnigan. That's Willie Joyce. This is Val Daly. And up in the corner for the ball. And running onto it is Tomás Tierney. Martin Griffin is penalised. And there's a free for Galway. And Martin is showing the referee, just what the referee showed Gay McManus a few moments ago. Honest, sir, I did it with my shoulder. Val Daly to take the kick. 13-metre line. You can see how near it is to the sideline. 1-9 to 9 points in favour of Donegal. And Noel McColl grabs it in the goal. But they're not out of the wood yet, because the ball is fielded by Richie Lee. In now to Peter Lee, and it's high and it's a point. The Lees have combined. They're not related, they're just good footballers. Peter Lee getting it from Richie Lee, and Richie sending it over the bar. The score now, Donegal 1-9. That's 12 points, Galway 10 points. And it looks as if John Coleman. No, it's not. It's Michael Brennan has come on. Michael Brennan is on the Galway team and Tom Nocton has gone off on the far side. Michael Brennan, top of the right. Tom Nocton, the captain, has gone off. And the referee giving a signal to the line that Richie Lee requires some kind of attention to his eye. That's Matty McDonagh coming out. They're coming out to have a look at him. But there's no way he wants to go off. He wants to get back into that game. 12 points to 10 in favour of Donegal. 12 points to 10 Brendan Dunleavy, Paul McGettigan, and Paul penalised for carrying the ball too far, and Donegal could easily let this slip. 3 for Galway, 65 metre line, their own 65 metre line. Again, 3 of them around to take it, just to the right. In fact, they've stolen a yard or two. It's on the halfway line now, and Johnny Hughes is the one who's going to take it. Lovely ball. Tomás Tierney. It's high, it's over the bar. The score now, Donegal 1-9, Galway, or Donegal 1-9, Galway 12, or 11 points, 1-9 to 11 points in favour of Donegal. That is 12 to 11. Almost 25 minutes gone in the second half. 1 point between them. Now, the youth and dash of Donegal, the experience of Galway, that's what's on the line. He got the free anyway, and the free will be taken by Stephen Joyce. Tommy McDermott following him all the way out, and the referee says give him room to take the kick. Pat O'Neill running up on the left wing now, but Stephen Joyce concentrating on the kick. It's out to the left, it's gone off Martin Griffin. He held on to it, it nearly bounced out over the line. Martin's clearance is shortish one. It goes to Charlie Mulgrew. 4 Galway men there. One of them is Gay McManus. This is Brian O'Donnell. This is Peter Lee. And that was Michael Carr blocking the ball down. Certainly Galway throwing everything at the Donegal defence now. And up to now, that defence standing solid. 1-9. That's 12 points for Donegal. 11 points for Galway. Stephen Joyce to take it, and again Tommy McDermott has followed him right out to the line. Is this the equaliser? Across comes Des Newton. Brendan Dunleavy. Matty Coleman. Seamus McHugh. Galway men down injured outfield. And Stephen Joyce pushed in the back. One of the Galway men injured in the centre of the field, but there is a free. To Galway, I should say, and it is just outside the 45 metre line. That is the Donegal 45 metre line, and they're attending to Peter Lee, who looks kind of days there. And indeed, they're calling for sideline assistance. And Peter Lee being attended to, as I say, they are calling. And this is the doctor associated with the Galway team, Matty McDonough, coming in as well. In fact, they are carrying Peter Lee off. No way does Peter want to go. But he obviously is in no condition to stay put. Now he's gone down again. Now Galway, in fact, have their three subs committed. They already have three subs on the field, so they are going to have to finish this match with 14 men. The John's ambulance now coming in with a stretcher. And Peter Lee, certainly, it takes a lot to knock Peter over, and he certainly is knocked over here. The score, Galway 111, Donegal 19, 2 points between them. And Galway now reduced to 14 men. And how strange it is that not 3 days ago I heard some of the Galway men say we often play better when we reduced to the 14 men. But there is Peter Lee. Anybody down there in Galway to think that you can knock over Peter Lee in a football game? Well, there he was, sitting up, showing everybody that he's not quite as bad as he was when it happened first. So off he goes. Galway reduced to 14 men. The score 111-19. A free just outside the 45-meter line, and a couple of minutes to be added on if the referee so decides. That would mean, well, we have 5 minutes on the stopwatch left in the game. And Gay McManus sends this one to the left and sends it wide. 111-19. Galway by 2 points. On the stopwatch, 5 minutes. The referee may, at his discretion, add extra time for that delay. And coming on, I think that Fintan Lynch, no, he is getting ready over on the far side. I think Donegal are going to indulge in some. Pádraig Carr, who played in the Ulster final, is coming on, and going off is Donal Reid. Donal Reid going off, number 10, just going to the dugout. The score 111-19. Ball down to Tommy McDermott. Up this side of the field to Joyce McMullen. Joyce McMullen through the centre. Coming across, grabbing the ball, Johnny Hughes. Johnny is held free for Galway. And again, Fintan Lynch is coming on the Donegal team on the far side. Referee says, hold on for a second. Fintan Lynch is on, and going off is Kieran. Yes, Kieran is going off, and Kieran Keeney going off the top of the left. Free taken. Gay McManus. And a free for Donegal. A free for Galway, I should say. Free for Galway, Stephen Joyce to take it. Just in under the shadow. Nice curling ball, a lovely punt! A lovely punt by Stephen Joyce. A curler that had point written all over it from the time it left his boot. Galway, 1-12. Donegal, 1-9. And about 3 minutes left of actual playing time. Whether the referee adds any extra time or not, well, we'd have to wait and see. And here comes Donegal. Pádraig Carr. And and they're trying all kinds of twisting and turning to get through. Fintan Lynch. And they're still trying for the goal as Paul McGettigan takes a shot towards the goal mouth. Out it comes now to Tommy McDermott. McDermott shot it high and it's a point. A point by Tommy McDermott, the right fullback. The score now, Galway, 1 goal and 12 points. Donegal, 1 goal and 10. 2 minutes, 2 points, but there may be extra time at the discretion of the referee. Corey Coyne. No hurry, telling everybody to move back. Gay McManus. Back to Val Daly. Val kicked it and made the Lord directed it. Could have gone to Kirkpatrick if it had only been slightly to the right. The score, 112 to 110 in favour of Galway. 2 points between them and time ticking away. Noel McCall to the centre of the field. Martin Griffin. Michael Carr. Brendan Dunleavy. Dunleavy fouled, a quickly taken free, and it just nearly goes the wrong way. Tommy McDermott. Seamus Bonner. Bonner right through now. Matty Coleman was there. Out to this side to Pat O'Neill. Pat being harassed by Charlie Mulgrew. And the referee has awarded a free out to Galway. It's to be taken by Stephen Kennedy. 112 to 110. 2 points between them now. Galway's experience, will they hold on? Tommy McDermott. And the whole Donegal team mounted now to win an attack. Joyce going right up the field. Joyce McMullen. He is fouled and there is a free. A free for the Donegal men. 35 metres out from the goal, the whole of Donegal, hills and all, are in around the goal. Martin McHugh is to take it. There's no use in him taking a point. They have to try a bit of engineering. Martin McHugh standing back now. The whole team, bar the goalkeeper and fullback, are up in the Galway half. It's crowded in there. Here comes the kick. He kicks it high. He sends it over the bar. There's now only 1 point between them. But time is ticking away. If the referee allows a bit of extra time for the injury, then Donegal have a chance. If he works strictly to the 35 minutes, the game is over. Let's see now what happens. Corey Coyne placing the ball for the kick out. He is walking slowly back. What would you do if you were in this place? And the ball held by Willie Joyce. And the drop ball there that could be expensive. Here comes the attack again from Donegal. Charlie Mulgrew out there, but Seamus McHugh is there. And the referee awards a free. To Galway. Looking at the watch now. Johnny Hughes to take it. 1 point between them. Johnny Hughes to take the kick. We're playing 2 minutes of injury time now at the game. By the experience of Galway by one single point. And I don't care where you come from, you have to take your hat off to the Donegal men for their great effort today. They look to have this game won, but then the hat comes off to Galway the Galway side that refused to be beaten. They looked to be well beaten halfway through the second half. And then bit by bit, Galway, after squandering away score after score, they got a grip of things, went into the lead, looked to have it won, and back then have come the Donegal win with a great grandstand finish at the end. And eventually it is Galway, Galway the experienced, Galway the courageous, who won by 112 to Donegal's 111. A game that had much going for it in the right way. There was a lot of boostering and drop passes and the like and missed kicks, but there was certainly a good deal of good football. And the crowd milling around as ever on the field, and the players making their way into the dressing room. There's Pádraig Kelly, who played a fine game until he went off in the second half for Galway. Tom Nocton went off too. And there just gone off, Michael Carr, one of the great players of the day, and I don't care whether you include Galway or Donegal or anybody else, one of the great footballers of the day, and that includes the minor game. Richie Lee, what a great game he had for Galway in the centre of the field. A lot indeed of swapping of jerseys and what have you. Well, a big day indeed for sport. Over in Helsinki, of course, Eamon Coughlin won the gold medal in the 5,000 metres. Here at Croke Park, Derry defeated Galway by 16 points to Galway's 3-5 in the All-Ireland minor semi-final. And in the first game, the Wynwood game, Leitrim were victorious 2-6 to Longford's 1-6. And in the senior game, by 1 point, we had a victory for Galway, who won by 1 goal and 12 points to 1 goal and 11 points for Donegal. The top scorer of the game, Martin McHugh, with 5 points. The top scorer for Galway, Val Daly, with a goal and a point. A game that was exciting, a game in which you take your hat off to the great courage of Galway to come back and use their knout, and you also take off your hat to the game display that Donegal put up in this their third unsuccessful effort to get to an All-Ireland final. But somehow I have an idea that it won't be too long before they do. And may I remind you that by winning today, that the Galway men have qualified to play the winners of next Sunday's game, Dublin versus Cork. And I do hope you will join us and enjoy that game on RTE next Sunday. Slán a gcuid, Galway.